Scriptures to the Philippians saying in verse 12 that he presses on to take hold of what Christ already took hold of for me. What Paul was saying here was that he wanted to be identified in Christ so that he could take hold of every blessing that belonged to him by right through Christ's sacrifice once and for all on the cross. This passage of scripture almost parallels directly with Hebrews 12 and 1, where Paul said, compared life to a race that is marked out for us. Because Christ ran this race for all of us to give us the prearranged victory when we get here in life. All we have to do is just be finishers of that same race in order to share in that victory. This is why the race is not given to the swift or the strong, but to he that endures. All you got to do is finish. Touch a mic, say finish. Finish. I ran cross country this year, and one of the races wasn't even about who came in first. It was just about to see who could last them 3 miles around that course. Touch somebody, say finish it. Finish your degree. Touch somebody, say finish it. Finish your walk with Christ. Finish it. Finish your ministry. Finish it. Walk in your purpose, but finish it. You ought to finish it today. So we got to finish. Jesus ran this race against the devil to eliminate his competition towards you. So all you've got to do is just put your best foot forward, run this race, jump the few hurdles that the enemy has left out there on the track, and finish. Somebody holler at me, finish. So this is what sets up the next point. Several people cannot put their best foot forward because they fail to see that the race that they are in has already been won. Can I say that one more time? Several people cannot put their best foot forward because they fail to see that the race that they are in has already been won. Many people fail to see life simply as running a race and finishing. This is because they catch sight of the twists and turns on the course. They focus on the distraction standing up against them in the crowd. And they start to feel the internal timer ticking faster and faster when they get to a certain place on the course that they feel they should be much further ahead of. But in response to this, God is saying, I've already leapt the devil multiple times. All you've got to do is finish. But in response to that, he's saying finish. Many people fail to see that the victory for everything that they will ever go through has already been won. You just have to live according to God's standards. What most persons have to learn is that the hardest part of running this race is beginning. Because if you start this race, you shall finish. Now in the text, Paul carefully details his Jewish customs that were recognized accomplishments outside of Christ that were of the flesh for a very good cause. And he does this. He lists these items that were of great importance in the Jewish community. Can I read them again? He lists them again. I just feel that we need to go back over that. He says in verse 4, I believe. Yes, it was. He says, if anybody thinks he has more reasons to put more confidence in the flesh, he says, I have more. I was circumcised on the eighth day. I'm of the people of Israel. I'm of the tribe of Benjamin. I'm a Hebrew of Hebrews. And in regard to the law, I'm a Pharisee. As for zeal, I persecuted the church. And for legalistic righteousness, I was faultless. So yes, he's saying that if you've got a reason to put confidence in your flesh, I have more. Because I was in the world much more deeper than you. You ain't got no reasons to think you can do more wickedness than I can, because I was with the world deeper than you ever were. So he's saying, yes, I've done my devilment, and I know I done much more dirt than you have. I done seen good, and I know what bad is too, and I can do bad all by myself. Yes, give God praise for your history. Give God praise for your history. You ought to give God praise for your history, because there are some fights that you will come through where you only be able to defeat your giants with your history. Can I work how I feel it? David, when he came to Goliath, said, I'll face the lion, I'll face the bear. Lions, tigers, bears, oh my. I'm going to get you and I'm going to have your head. So when you get a bill that come up against you next month, say, I paid last year's bills and I ain't missed one as of yet. So this time, this ain't meaning nothing. I'm going to let my history defeat my giant. You've got to remember, you've got to recall the things that God has done for you, not so you can gloat and say, look what I've accomplished, but so you can say, I have pride in where I have been and I have the faith for where I can go. So I want you to know that when Paul did this, he also leveled the playing field among those who feel that they are really doing something with themselves, but to no avail as regards to their salvation. So in other words, the man-made achievements that people outside of Christ try to stack up on each other one after another to be able to trust in themselves is just a tower of insecurities. This is because they already know they are not strong enough to support themselves. So the next point to this message is some people cannot put their best foot forward because they cannot recognize their human weaknesses. Some people cannot put their best foot forward because they cannot recognize their human weaknesses. And speaking to what has already been said, some of us, after knowing Christ, still try to carry and support ourselves because being strong was all that many of us have ever known to do. And trusting in ourselves was the only person that we could turn to after being deceived many times before we met Christ. So the tendency still remains for some of us to still have confidence in the flesh, thinking that we can advance ourselves in society with our accomplishments. But how many know that elevation comes from the Lord? We think that we can advance ourselves aided by our own strength, as Paul stated in verse 4. But in Christ, as I revert back to verse 8, Paul said it is all a loss, revealing that it all means nothing, because what we achieve on this earth is nothing when compared to knowing the greatness of God. And because when he sees us, he sees us all as equals, without the titles, without the accomplishments, without the degrees, without the material goods. He sees you as the greatness that he has put inside of you. How many people that success and greatness differ much, very greatly? Because success can be measured by material goods. Greatness is instilled in you. So how many know that greatness cannot be measured? You are great as much as you say you are. If you feel that you can achieve great things, then you can do it. You just got to finish it. You just got to go for it and put your best foot forward. How many ever play hokey pokey? Put your right foot in and put your right foot out. But in this case, we're not taking our feet out. Put your right foot in. Put your left foot in. Put your right foot in and keep on going. How many know that as far as you go depends on how prepared you are to go? If you fail to plan, then you plan to fail. So I want you to know that we can work for what we have accomplished in life, but don't only live for what you work for. For only what you do for Christ will last. The last and final point to this message is that I want to present to you is that some people cannot put their best foot forward because they are still fighting with yesterday. This is a detail to the message where the struggle for several keeps growing. This is because we are either running back back towards our history, or we have never put an end to certain things that are that remain to be going, be ongoing from the past. So some of us are struggling to fight against 3 and 5 years of history that has never been put to a close. We are fighting to bridge the gap between yesterday and tomorrow, but the issues of yesteryear are keep tearing us down. But Paul said, as I press forward to the prize of the mark of the high calling, which means that no former thing in my past can look so good that it can damage my direct, it can change my direction away from the best of things that is ahead of me. Because I have